I'm Wendell Potter, and for 20 years I worked in the insurance industry. I left my corporate job in 2008, and since then I've been speaking out about why Americans have to put up with the most expensive and one of the most dysfunctional healthcare systems on the planet. I'm also writing about it as an analyst at the Center for Public Integrity and as the author of Deadly Spin, an insurance company insider speaks out on how corporate PR is killing healthcare and deceiving Americans.
The healthcare reform bill is just a little more than a year old now, and it has a lot of aspects, a lot of provisions that are very good, that they really protect the rights of patients.
And it means access to quality, affordable healthcare. That is part of the American dream.
What we need to watch in the future is what really is going on in Congress and in the state capitals.
The new healthcare law, think about this a minute, creates 159 new agencies, commissions, panels, and other bodies. It grants extraordinary powers to the Department of Health and Human Services to redefine healthcare as we know it.
Many special interests benefit from the way the healthcare system in this country has operated for many years. And one of those special interests are insurance agents and brokers. They want to make sure that they're not excluded in this new world of healthcare in this country. So they are very much trying to make sure that when the exchanges are set up and when the medical loss ratio is determined by Congress, that their commissions are protected. One of the things that they're doing is to fund an organization that they're calling the Choice and Competition Coalition, which is essentially a front group with money coming from them to try to persuade the public that we should let them market everything, and that including the products that are essentially junk insurance. One of the things that we'll be hearing from the insurers is that this legislation will indeed restrict competition and that it will cause, consequently, our rates to go up. So we'll be hearing that a lot of these consumer protections will be directly resulting in higher premiums. They don't want to give up being able to offer junk insurance or these policies that are often called mini-meds. They've been getting temporary waivers for them to continue to sell these products. In 2014, theoretically or by law, they're supposed to go away. But you can rest assured that these companies will be fighting to change the law so that they can continue to market junk insurance. The reason is because it's very profitable for them. So they will want to make sure that they're doing whatever they can to preserve their profits. Wall Street is expecting them to do this, and we've got to keep an eye on that.